Welcome to the ET-335 oscilloscope external trigger video. Okay, let's start up our diagram here and let's do some oscilloscope work. So we're going to turn it on, and the first channel we're going to look at is channel 1. Let's go ahead and go to 5 volts. Spread our timing out so we can see them. And first thing we want to do is trigger on the slowest one. Since we only have one channel, let's just go ahead and trigger on channel 1. Okay, good. Auto coupling, that's good. So now what we're going to do is do our trigger level. And what we want to do when we trigger is have the yellow arrow, channel 1, pointed to channel 1 to lock it. So let's turn on channel 2. Bring it down to 5 volts, and let's move him down, and let's move yellow up, the other up, there we go, and let's move channel 2 up. Okay, see how it's out of sync, we can't see it, so we need to trigger off of channel 2. So we're going to go back to trigger menu and we're going to go to channel 2, which is our slowest one out of the two. So now they're both locked. Okay, and let's open up, turn on channel 3, bring it down to 5 volts, and let's position it down. Good. And it's kind of a latch, but what we should be doing is going to our and changing our lock channel 3. Good. So let's go to channel 4 and let's get him to 5 volts. Good. And let's move him down. And he is not locked at all. Okay, so let's go to channel 3, channel 4, excuse me, and let's go ahead and move that up, and we should be locked on all of them. And it is not. Let's go ahead and change our time delay, see if we can, there we go. And it's locked now. And we have it on rising edge, and you can see that we are triggering off our rising edge right here. Okay, so now what we can do, let's go ahead and turn this off. Let's take our trigger menu, our trigger, and let's run it off our last channel. Okay. And how about we do this? Let's break. And hang on a second. Let's go ahead and not use 4, but we're going to use our trigger menu, our trigger input. And let's go ahead and start it again. And it should lock, lose lock. And it did. But if we go to our trigger menu and go to external trigger, right there. Now it's locked again. So this external trigger will allow us to trigger our display wherever we want it. Back in the old days, we would not have 4 channels. We'd have 2 channels, and we would use our trigger in order to trigger off the slowest one, which would have been the green channel here, which didn't exist. So the trigger is a way to lock our display. On a counter would be our slowest, but we could utilize our external trigger to trigger on certain events and then lock that in place. And that's our external trigger.